Hi guys, it's Kyle. Welcome. How you doing? Hey.
Sorry, gumalaw. Yun eh, ang ganda ni kaso gumalaw na eh.
Saka yung upo mo talaga sa gilid mo gusto.
Paano ba magusto mo upo?
Hi guys.
Yeah, I'm a smoke again. 3, 2, 1, rolling.
Hey guys, it's Kyle. What's up? How you doing?
Hey Kyle, we're good. Welcome to Spotlight, of course. So, first off, we're doing this kasi to ask you a few questions to get to know you better. First question ko, ano yung expectations mo sa Spotlight?
Ano yung expectations ko? Actually, I might show you guys my whole self. I don't know if I'm gonna show you content about me, pero I'm ready. I'm excited for this.
Second question, ano yung current LSS mo going here?
Current LSS, talk by Colleen.
Wow, how tall are you?
How tall am I? I think 6 foot. Plata. Mm. Straight 6 now.
What's Kyle's nationality?
Kyle's nationality. I am only Filipino po kasi lahat naman tayo may Spanish. Pero my grandpa is 100% Spanish, so I'm half Spanish, half Sardines.
How is it like being half Spanish, half Sardines? No kidding. How is it like being tall?
Okay po. Pero actually feeling ko it's weird kasi pag nandito po ako sa Pinas, matangkad po ako. Pero pag nasa States po, medyo average height lang ako. So whenever I go there, kasi dun po ako lumaki. When I went there for vacation, lahat ng mga kaibigan ko, kasing tangkad ko. The one I want here, mga kaibigan. Konti, may mga mas
Pero totoo bang mas okay yung hangin sa taas?
Hindi ko na pinapansin, pero I guess.
Curious kami, what's it like being Kyle?
What's it like being Kyle? Very weird, fun, I guess, and I guess for me, medyo, I really think that I am blessed, so I'm very happy.
We also know naman na, aside from being a singer, mamaya pag-usapan natin yan, you also delved into acting.
Yes.
First, yung Otwal. Balikan naman natin, ano yung mga naging highlights ng Otwal experience?
Yan yung pinaka first acting experience ko. Si Tita Isa, yung mom ko, she was so helpful with all my acting. Leo Bryan po yung dad ko dun, he was really helpful sa acting ko. Especially, kasi naging English po ako dun. Hindi po talaga ako marunong magpo or Tagalog kasi dun po ako lumaki sa States. So, yung mother tongue ko was really just English. So, pare, I had a lot of fun kasi yung director naman, si Direct Tonet, she was helping me with everything. And Direct Jojo, which is actually my director now for Kadena Ginto. So I was very happy because everyone was helping me.
Speaking of Kadena Ginto, from something medyo light outward, yung Kadena Ginto medyo kasi to medyo awayan. Tapos afternoon, kamusta yung experience mo naman sa KG?
Sa KG, sobrang masaya. Because yung buong cast mo namin is parang pamilya lang. We're all very close. It's not work. It's more of a having fun sa trabaho. Kasi also, Direk Jerry is one of our directors din po. He's very, very helpful in all our lines and kung paano namin idala yung lines and the story. And the story is so nice. Sobrang na-inlove ako sa story namin. So, I'm having a lot of fun din po sa Kadena Ginto.
Then we know that you're also part of Seven Sundays.
Yes.
With all the boys. So, kamusta yung experience na yung first movie mo so far?
Nakaka-nerve-wracking po talaga kasi una-una, yung director po namin was Direk Cathy. Yung dad ko doon was Tito Agamula. Then yung tito ko doon was Tito Dingdong. And then there was Kuya Ken. So, sobrang star-studded po yung cast, especially with Tita Christine, Ate Christine Reyes. And, pero doon, naging pamilya din po kami. We were all very close during set. So yun, I had a lot of fun there. A lot of fun.
How is it like delving into acting when we know now you're more of a singer talaga?
How is it like diving in? First, it was very nerve-wracking kasi especially pag sinabihan ako na may Tagalog akong lines. At first, sobrang natatakot po ako pag may Tagalog akong line. Kasi I wasn't very good with Tagalog. Pero ngayon, I'm getting more fluent with my Tagalog, so it's making my acting a little more fluid. And actually, nung bata pa lang po ako, I've always wanted to do acting. So it was a dream of mine to be a singer slash actor.
Mm-hmm. Pero sabi mo bata pa, medyo dream mo mag-acting. Pero what really pushed you to try it on?
Nung pumunta po ako dito sa Star Magic, sabi ni Mr. M na gusto mong i-try yung acting. Mm-hmm. Una, naging skeptical po ako. Pero he pushed me and I was able to do it. Then when I did On the Wings of Love, that's when I fell into acting po talaga. I fell in love with acting.
Meron akong dalawang question siya. Mamili ka lang ng isa. Cassie or Marga?
Ah! Cassie or Marga, hindi po Marga. Hindi po Andrea or Francine.
Cassie or Marga?
Cassie or Marga. Kung ako po si Christoph, syempre yung pipiliin niya ngayon is Cassie. Pero kaibigan niya din talaga si Marga. So,
eto. Second, acting or singing?
Acting or singing, cool. Kung papiliin po talaga ako, acting is a second for me. Kasi I love singing. It's my first love. Mm.
Heto naman, can you share the story behind this photo?
Oh! Etong picture na to, 8 years ago, so I was how old? I was 8 years old. I was 8 years old dito. Eto, I was 8 years old. Marunong na po ako mag-bike. I know how to ride a dirt bike when I was actually 2 years old. Pero this is, nag-camping po kami sa desert. Actually, every weekend po, nag-camping po kami sa States. And then we like to go dirt biking, going sa mga trails. And this is just one of the memories.
Have you adjusted that to the Filipino culture?
Yes. Kasi actually before pa po, nasa States po, lagi po akong nag-rice. I can't eat chicken without rice. So that was a start. Kasi my mom would always cook for us. Filipino food lang po talaga. Mm-hmm. So when I came here, actually, at first I didn't want to come here po kasi I was nervous sa culture shock. Mm-hmm. Pero when I came here, I felt like this was my home. Mm-hmm. So I found my home here and I was able to transform into a more Filipino vibe of lifestyle.
How would your friends describe you?
How would my friends describe me? Makulit. Matangkad. Mm-hmm. Annoying.
Yeah. At least aminado ka.
Pero I'm friendly at the same time and I like to care about my friends sometimes more than I care about myself. Mm-hmm.
I also know that you've been part of ASFG.
Yes.
How was the experience? Ano ba yun?
That was fun. Sobrang saya. That was a way for me to learn more into dancing, more than just singing. And all of us, we were really good group of friends. I see we would help each other with choreography every time. And then Teacher G would help us too because we would have to go two times. Instead of one day rehearsals, we would try doing two. Para swak na swak yung performance namin. So it was all on out roller coaster experience.
Ito naman, kasi nakikita namin naman yung photos ni Bella, yung baby sister mo. How close are you and how do you guys bond?
Sobrang close po kami. Mahal na mahal ko po yung kapatid ko. I can never let her have a boyfriend. I told her when she's 80, she's allowed to have a boyfriend. So, I'm very protective. Pero I love her so much. We bond by playing on the phone sometimes. Pero lagi po siya nasa kwarto ko. Nag-hangout lang po kami para ng bonding.
Mm-hmm. I think mas strict ka pa kay mommy mo.
Yes po. Pero mas parang kasing strict ko po yung dad ko.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Kwento mo naman kami, whichever part ng life mo, ano yung life story ni Kyle na gusto niya i-share today?
Life story ni Kyle na gusto mong i-share today? Gusto mong i-share na nagpapasalamat po talaga ako. Like, at this moment in my life, right now, I'm very happy with what's been happening to me. I'm very blessed and I'm very excited for my future. Mm-hmm. So, and I want to say thank you to everyone who's watching. Maraming salamat sa lahat ng mga sumusuporta sa akin. Kung hindi dahil sa inyo, wala po ako dito. So, maraming salamat.
Speaking of being happy, what are the things that make Kyle happy?
What are the things that make Kyle happy? There's a list of many, many things. Siyempre, yung pamilya ko. mahal na mahal ko sila. They always make me happy whenever I'm feeling down. My friends, of course. May mga friends na masasabi ko talaga na totoong kaibigan talaga. Mm-hmm. Bilang artista na friend.
Mm-hmm.
They're all really good friends. And then, of course, my fans. Mm-hmm. Kayo yung nagpapalaki ng ngiti ko. You guys make me so happy every single day. So, I love you guys so much. And of course, God. Number one, actually, si God. Siyempre, mm-hmm. Number one si God.
Ano naman mga nakakapagpainis kay Kel?
Ano po?
Nakakapagpainis.
Nakakapagpainis sa
mm-hmm.
Mga pet peeves?
Yeah, pet peeves.
Pet peeves. Yung kailangan kong ulitin yung mga sinasabi ko kahit ilang beses na akong umulit.
Mm-hmm.
Yung parang, ano yan? Ano yan? Ano yan? Then, it's so... Parang na-irritate ako. And then the fork sa plate, pag kina-scratch, yun yung isa ka pet peeve. It's yung...
Masakit sa tenga.
Masakit sa tenga. Yun po.
Mm-hmm. Can you share a recent embarrassing experience or all-time embarrassing experience mo?
All-time embarrassing experience ko. Ewan ko kung ipapashare ko to kasi medyo embarrassing nga talaga. I think I was 8. No, I wasn't 8. Mas bata pa ako. It's very, very embarrassing kasi I was young. Hindi ko alam. So, like, nagsashower po ako. No, my brother was using the CR. Pero natatae ako. Hindi ako makagagalaw papunta sa second CR. So, tumay ako sa shower.
Oh,
all time embarrassing yun. And then, nakita ng buong pamilya ko yung tayo ko sa CR. Sa shower. So, yun na.
Embarrassing. Tama.
Napaka-embarrassing.
Tell us one thing naman that we have to know about you. One, or not too many people know about you.
Not too many people know about you. I'm a family guy. Not much people know about that, pero inuuna ko po talaga ang pamilya ko kasi mahal ko po talaga sila.
Speaking of your family, share mo naman sa amin ilang kids sa family, paano kayo nagbabad, ano mga trip, ano yung kailan ka huling napagalitan at bakit ka napapagalitan?
So, lima po kami sa pamilya namin. There's my dad, of course, my mom. Then, tatlo po kami magkakapatid. Yung isa ko pong brother, which is older than me, yung panganay po sa amin, he's living by himself now kasi gusto niya maging independent siya.
Mm-hmm.
My little sister is the one that I love the most because I care about her so much. Pero yung pag-bonding ko namin every Sunday or every other Sunday since yung dad ko po nasa Cebu ngayon, dun po siya nakatira kasi dun po yung business namin. So, dun po siya nakatira every other week. He comes here to Manila and then every Sunday po family day po kami, kumakain ng Korean, nagmo-mall, and then, yung last time na pagalitan ako was, ano po siguro yun? Yung nagpi-PS4 po ako, parate. So, na-addict po ako dun. So, my dad got mad, and my mom got mad kasi I wasn't doing anything kundi PS4.
Very usual. Let's talk about your favorites naman.
Oh, sorry.
Okay. Favorite comfort food?
Favorite comfort food? Oh!
Sad, whatever.
Siyempre, I always like having a burger with fries.
Mm-hmm.
That's the best way to go. Or pizza.
Favorite dessert?
Favorite dessert? Vanilla ice cream.
Least favorite food?
Least favorite food? Veggies. Di naman all veggies, pero most. Most talaga.
Nag-ano ka pa din ha? Nag-qualify ka pa din.
Yeah.
Favorite pastime?
Favorite pastime, PS4. Or mga hobbies ko are like sports. I like to play a lot of sports.
So, anong sports mo?
Basketball, which are football. And anything that has to do with the ball, I always play sports.
Favorite book?
Hindi po ako nababasa ng
movie. I'm honest.
Honest po ako. Power of the Actor.
Favorite songs? Ito.
Favorite songs? All time po ba?
All time.
All time. Well, my life song as of now is Get You by Daniel Caesar. diba? Or a song that I dedicate to someone would have to be Japanese Denim by Daniel Caesar. There's a lot of songs, like by Rush, there's a song called Ain't Nobody Taking My Baby. But most of my music really comes from Justin Bieber, Khalid, Rush, Daniel Caesar, Michael Jackson, of course, the number one. And then, mahilig po talaga ako sa 80s na music.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so I'm also into any genre, to be honest.
So yun yung mga favorite singers mo. Favorite cover song naman, na parang pwedeng forever.
Favorite cover songs?
Mm-hmm.
Pwedeng pakinggan forever. Like songs that I like to cover?
Pwede mo gusto mo i-cover or mga covers na gusto mo pinakinggan?
Of course, I met Justin Vasquez, who's a really good singer. He does a lot of covers, mga Tagalog songs, mga international songs. I met him. I love the way he sings. Mga riffs niya, I always get inspiration from the way he sings. There's a lot of different people, like Alex Ayono.
Mm-hmm.
And I always get like different variations sa pagkanta sa kanila.
Favorite actor or actress, pwedeng local or international?
Actor, I'll do international muna. Denzel Daniel. Denzel Washington.
Mm-hmm.
Paborito ko po siya.
Yeah.
Can you guys put a map? Because I keep doing it. Denzel Washington. I'm a big fan of him because his acting is so natural.
Mm-hmm.
There's also Michael B. Jordan. Napakagaling po siyang actor. Dito Pusa Pinas, of course, si Tito Aro Mulak. He helped me so much po nung 7 Sundays and I had so much fun working with him. Of course, there's Tito Piolo Pascual.
Mm-hmm.
Inigo Pascual. And, yeah, mga ganyan.
Favorite TV shows? Pwedeng nag-air, pwedeng local, pwedeng international.
Favorite TV show? Number one po, favorite TV show po ngayon is Katay ng Ginto. di po ako masyadong TV eh. I'm very digital. I'm very into YouTube, mga ganyan.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm not very into TV. Pero when I watch TV talaga, it's always the Unprovinciano. Katay ng Ginto, of course, again. And, and yun po.
Favorite movies na lang.
Favorite movies? Black Panther.
Mm-hmm.
Man on Fire by Denzel Washington. There's this one movie. Nakalimutan ko yung pangalan niya. Denzel Washington din siya. Basta lahat ng Denzel Washington na movie, sobrang gusto ko. Local naman po. Alone Together was such a beautiful movie. The House of Lush, because Darren Espanto was in it and it was absolutely amazing. He's such a good actor. And then, yun po.
Favorite country you visited?
Favorite country you visited? Visited lang. Mm-hmm. Pero my favorite country all in all, of course, the Philippines.
Mm-hmm.
Visited. I was in Korea for about a couple hours, but I really want to go there again. No, I'm going to stop over lang po ako. Pero I loved
Mexico.
Oh yeah. Nung bata po ako, every summer I always went to Mexico. There was Cancun, Puerto Vallarta, but I love Cancun, Mexico.
Favorite country that you want to visit?
That I want to visit.
Yeah.
Spain. Kasi dun po yung roots ko, Valencia po sila nakatira rin. I want to go to Spain so bad. I have some of my Echarri family from my dad's side in Valencia, so I want to go there.
Favorite kind of vacation?
Favorite kind of vacation? Basta, actually, I like a mix of pagkasama pa yung pamilya tsaka kaibigan, and beach. Basta beach is my favorite. I love Dagatero ako.
Favorite carnival or theme park ride?
Favorite carnival or theme park ride? Disneyland, of course. Nung nakapunta po ako dun, actually 30 minutes lang po yung bahay namin sa Disneyland dati. So I always went to Disneyland and I went to California Screamin'. Isang time na 8 times po ako pumunta. I went on the ride 8 times straight.
Favorite expression?
Happy! Mag-smile ka parate, because it helps your day, so, well.
Okay, let's go to your career naman. How did you start in the business, bro?
How did I start? I auditioned po for The Voice Kids Season 2, and nakapasok po ako, and I was super excited and nervous at the same time.
So walk us through naman dun sa The Voice Kids experience.
The Voice Kids po yung pinakauna kong competition na nasali ko. I was super nervous kasi I was not ready. Para sa akin, I don't think I was ready. Pero I was able to pull through and I was very happy kasi Ate Shara believed in me and I thank her so much for my career today.
Pero how did you become so good in singing? Meron bang singer
sa family? Wow, so good!
Yeah! How did you become so good? Nag-train ka ba? May singer ba sa family? May iba ka mag-video? Okay, ano ba?
Actually, never po ako nag-training until I started The Voice. When I got into The Voice, that's when I started joining SOR, which was my music school po dati, in Cebu. And I guess naman ako po siguro sa dad ko, because my dad was the singer of my family, pero this is how it works. My dad likes singing, my dad is a good singer, but he doesn't like singing. My mom likes singing, but singing does not like her.
Okay, noted. So, anong genre talaga yung pinaka-comfortable
ka? Genre? R&B pop lang po siguro. Mm-hmm. Tama tipo siguro Sempi and Daniel Caesar type.
Mm-hmm. Pero ito naman, dito naman pagpasok mo sa showbiz, 'di ba? Pagpasok mo sa acting rather, sabi mo sa Mr. M, siya yung isa sa mga nagpo-share to try it on. Pero may part ba at any point sa buhay mo na naisip mo gusto mong mag-acting talaga or wala or singer talaga gusto mong i-pursue?
I thought nung 7 Sundays po, I realized na medyo comfortable po ako sa acting. Pero di ko po talaga maiwanan ng singing. Kasi alam ko doon po ako nag-start. And that's how, that was my first ever dream to become a singer. Mm-hmm. So, I guess, yeah, it never came to mind. Pero I've always wanted to put them together.
Mm-hmm. Have you ever had naman a starstruck moment? Ano nangyari?
May isang ASAP po. Actually, after po ng 7 Sundays po ito, mm-hmm. nag-ASAP po ako, kasama si Ate Liza Sobrano po nun.
Mm-hmm.
Nagpa-picture po ako sa kanya. After po ako nagpa-picture sa kanya, sabi niya, ang galing mo sa 7 Sundays ha, keep it up.
Aww.
So I was like, oh my God! Na-starstruck ako, bigla akong nag-blush, my whole face turned red. Mm-hmm. And I didn't even say anything to her. I said, thank you, and I went like this.
Quite understandable naman.
Yeah, sobrang natakot ako.
Pero sino pa yung mga gusto mo makatrabaho? Pwedeng maka-collaborate sa music or sa acting?
Collaborate sa music naman. Of course, my brothers, Darren Espanto and Inigo Pascual. Mm-hmm. I'd love to work on a song with them. Inigo actually wrote a song for me, pero di naabot sa album ko. Maybe my second album, if I have one, he's gonna help me out. Darren, we've been thinking about writing a song together for a while now, and we might do a cover soon.
Mm-hmm. Tapos, ano naman ang dream role mo naman?
Dream role? I guess, I've always wanted to be a leading man.
Mm-hmm.
Kahit anong genre po, ibibigay sa akin, okay lang po sa akin. I'm very happy with any blessing that's given to me.
Mm-hmm. Pero kasi, since ito nga, nandito ka na, nung nag-The Voice ka, anong nag-inspire sa'yo na talagang i-pursue na mag-showbiz ka?
Hmm.
Kasi pwede namang hindi, di ba?
Opo. Pero after The Voice, ang dami po nagsasabi na ituloy mo lang to.
Mm-hmm.
Kaya mo yan. A lot of people were motivating me. I didn't know kung gusto ko pang mag-acting or mag-singing or balik na ako sa Cebu. Pero on the wings of love po, they were asking me if I was gonna stay here. Kung dito na po ako titira sa Manila. I didn't have a house here yet. Pero sabi nila, depende sa'yo kung gusto mo mahaba yung role mo or gusto mo extra ka lang. Mm-hmm. So, I said, sige, I'll take the long role. And then after that, madami pong mga blessings na dumating sa akin. So, I was very happy. And I took in everything and I realized na showbiz is for me. I really want to do it.
Mm-hmm. If you could remake naman one show or movie and be part of it, anong show or movie kaya ito?
Show or movie, maging parte po ako.
Mm-hmm.
kahit maging kapatid po ako ni Liza Sobrano, okay lang po. Basta makasama ko po si Ate Liza, okay lang.
Ano naman ang ano, mantra mo? Showbiz mantra mo?
Mantra mo?
Mantra, I mean, more of yung belief mo na parang baon mo sa as you venture dito sa showbiz.
Like a motto that I keep with me?
Yeah, like a motto.
Well, my dad always told me, always enjoy what you're doing. If you're not enjoying what you're doing, don't do it at all, or else you're gonna waste the rest of your life.
Mm-hmm.
So I always make sure that I'm enjoying my sa pagkanta, and I always make sure that lahat ng mga scenes ko, lahat ng mga performance ko, treat it as if it's your last.
Mm-hmm. Eto, meron kami mga ilang questions na lang. Would you rather be poor but help people, or become incredibly rich by hurting people?
Be poor but help people.
Would you rather live without the internet or live without the AC and heating? AC na lang, given the summer heat.
I don't know. Kasi dito sa Pinas, kailangan talaga yung aircon para sa akin. Actually, nakatapat po yung aircon ko sa ulo ko when I sleep.
Okay.
So, I don't know. AC na lang siguro.
So, mas hindi mo kaya wala internet na?
Abo, I guess.
Eto, would you rather have a horrible job but be able to retire comfortably in 10 years, or have your dream job but have to work until the day you die?
Dream job. Mm-hmm. I guess, yeah. Dream job.
Eto naman, would you rather find your true love or a suitcase with $5 million inside?
Oof. Huh. Well, since bata pa lang ako, siyempre, $5 million.
Sa totoo lang. Ito, last question. Would you rather be able to teleport anywhere or be able to read Liza Soberano's mind?
Whoa! Medyo creepy kasi yung pag-re-read ng mind ni Ate Liza. I want her to keep her privacy. So I'll teleport anywhere na lang.
Okay, those are all the questions, guys.
Yay.
Thank you!
Thank you!